The aggregate function is the Swiss Army knife of functions. It's so versatile, it can replace these 19 Excel functions in one fell swoop. But that's not reason enough to use it. The function killer reason to use aggregate over any of the 19 standard functions it can replace is because it's far more powerful. Let me show you. Here I have a table of data. It's formatted in an Excel table called Table 1. I can automatically put the total for the table at the bottom by selecting Total Row. But if you have a large table, you don't want to be scrolling to the bottom to get the total. Plus, I might also want multiple values like average and max. So what do? Put a formula at the top. If I use sum to get the total viewers, and then if I filter the table, sum includes the filtered rows. Now, this might be what you want, but most of the time you'll want to respect the filtered state, in which case we can use aggregate. Now, aggregate has two forms. I'll move the tooltip so we can see it. We can either use it in array or reference form. Now, the form is dictated by the function number that you choose. Now, functions 1 through 13 are reference form, and 14 to 19 are array form. And I'll cover more on this shortly. For now, I'll enter 9 for sum. The second argument for aggregate is options, which enables you to tell it how to handle hidden rows, or error values, nested subtotal, and aggregate functions. I'll use number 5, which ignores hidden rows, which really means rows hidden by filter because rows hidden manually are always ignored. And lastly, I'll want to sum the viewers column. Now, if I filter the region, you can see the total returned excludes the filtered rows. You might have noticed that the aggregate function is similar to the subtotal function, except it enables you to choose whether to ignore filtered rows or not. Plus, it can handle arrays. Let's take a look. I'll use it to find the two largest results. Put some labels in. First highest and second highest. Equals aggregate. 14 is the number for large. And I'll ignore hidden rows. And the array is the viewers column. In the K argument, I can enter one number here, say 2, if I wanted to return the second largest result. Or if I want to return multiple results, I can enter them in curly braces. I want them returned in a column, so I'll separate them with the semicolon. But if you want them returned in a row, just separate them with a comma. And the second result I want is the second largest value. I'll close the curly brace and close aggregate. And because I have dynamic arrays, the results spill. And if I remove the filter on the table, you can see it respects the filtered state. That's pretty cool, but let's look at something outside the box. Option numbers 2, 3, 6, and 7 enable you to ignore error values, and we can exploit this by forcing errors to exclude values we don't want to aggregate. Let's say I want to find the smallest amount that's greater than average. This time I'll use function number 15 for small. And I want to ignore error values, so I'll use option number 6. And in the array, I want to find the viewers, which I'll divide by a logical test. Remember, logical tests return true and false values, and when you perform a math operation on these values, in this case divide, they'll convert to their numeric equivalents of 1 and 0. The logical tests need to be wrapped in parentheses, and I'm finding the viewers that are greater than the average viewers, close parentheses, and then I simply want 1 to return the smallest value above average. Let's look at how it evaluates. So selecting the logical test, you can see it returns true and false values. And we take the values in the viewers column, and then we divide them by the logical test. We get div errors because values that were divided by false, which is effectively dividing by 0, returns an error. And the values that were divided by true, which is the same as 1, are returned. And because I selected 6 in the option argument, the errors will be ignored and aggregate will return the smallest value, which is 138. Now, something to be aware of is aggregate will not ignore filtered rows, nested subtotals, or nested aggregates if the array argument includes a calculation, as it did in the last example. If I filter the table to exclude the north region, which has the smallest value greater than average, and then I change the option number to 7, which is ignoring errors and hidden rows, the result doesn't change, and that's something to watch out for. Some other limitations you should be aware of. Aggregate is designed to work with data in columns, so when you reference a horizontal range, aggregate will not ignore values in hidden columns. It only ignores hidden rows in a vertical range. And aggregate will not ignore rows hidden manually using right-click hide. If this is required, then use the subtotal function. Now that you've mastered aggregate, check out my lesson on how to use it with slices and tables to create dynamic reports in this video next. Thanks for watching. See you in the next one.